بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. خطبتنا اليوم عن رمضان والدعاء. أيها المسلمون الكرام، أيها الصائمون، إن الله تعالى وسيع الفضل والمنة، وسيع الفضل والمنة، وعطاياه جزيلة ووافرة للصائم في شهر رمضان. ومن هذه العطايا النفيسة من الكريم، النفيسة من الكريم سبحانه وتعالى إلى عبد الصائم في رمضان الدعوة المستجابة. فقد تفضل الله سبحانه وتعالى عليك أيها الصائم بأن جعل لك دعوة مستجابة جزاء على صومك وتكريما لك. وفي سورة البقرة بعد أن ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى الصيام وشهر رمضان، قال تعالى وإذا سألك، قال تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، وإذا سألك عبادي عني فإني قريب أجيب دعوة الداعي إذا دعان فليستجيبوا لي وليؤمنوا بي لعلهم يرشدون. وقد بشرنا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بأن الدعوة الصائم مستجابة، كما في الحديث أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن لله عتقاء في كل يوم وليلة، لكل عبد صائم، لكل عبد صائم منهم دعوة مستجابة، رواه أحمد. وفي حديث أخرى عنه صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن الصائم عند فطره لدعوة ما ترد، رواه ابن ماجه. وتذكر أيها العبد الصائم قبل أن تدعو بهذه الدعوة المستجابة، تذكر بأن الدعاء أكرم شيء، بأن الدعاء أكرم شيء على الله تعالى. فكما قال في الحديث، فكما قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس شيء أكرم على الله تعالى من الدعاء. وكن موقنا بأن الله تعالى سيستجيب لك. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ادعوا الله وأنتم موقنون بالإجابة، واعلموا أن الله لا يستجيب دعاء من قلب لائم. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعد. وبعد، dear Muslims, brothers and sisters, our topic today is going to be about the significance of making dua in this blessed month of Ramadan. Dear Muslims, among Allah's favors in this blessed month is that He subhanahu wa ta'ala grants the supplications of His fasting slaves. For the slaves of Allah, for the slaves of Allah who fast for the sake of Allah, He subhanahu wa ta'ala gives him the honor of being close to him and answering his prayers. In Surah Al-Baqarah, at the end of the verses that talk about the month of Ramadan and fasting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي لَعَلَّهُمْ يَرْشُدُونَ. Meaning that when my slaves ask you concerning me, I am indeed closed to them. I respond to the prayer of every supplicant when he calls on me. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says there are three types of people whose supplications is not rejected: the fasting person until he breaks his fast, the just leader, and the supplication of the oppressed person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rises it up above the clouds and opens the gates of heavens to it. And he subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I shall surely come to your support, even if after a time. In another hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, in Ramadan, every night and day, there are people who are freed from fire, and every fasting slave has his supplications answered. Dear Muslims, supplication with full sincerity is a form of worship. One should make a serious effort to make his prayer come from the bottom of his heart and beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sincerely. He should express his poverty to the most gracious being. He subhanahu wa ta'ala says, meaning that call upon your Lord humbly and privately. He does not love the aggressors. In Quran chapter 7 verse 55. This means that the prayer should be made with a humble heart and sincere faith. The fasting person should realize at the time of breaking his fast that he is breaking his fast on a prayer, as it is his food and drink for the night. He should ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with his beautiful names, present himself to him in the form of a beggar in the court of a king. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves his slaves when they pray to him. The Prophet, peace be upon him, said, there is nothing more honorable to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than supplication. It is also required that when a person supplicates to Allah, he should be certain that his prayers will be answered. And remember that Allah does not answer a prayer which comes out of and we should know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not answer a prayer which comes from unmindful and heedless heart. As the Prophet, peace be upon him, said, supplicate to Allah and be sure that he will answer you. And be aware that Allah never answers the supplications of someone who is careless. Also, while praying, it is commendable. That the person should try to raise his hands up, because the Prophet, peace be upon him, says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kind and most generous and is too kind to return his slave's hands empty after he has raised them to him in supplication. Dear Muslim, there is no restriction in asking Allah. He has everything. His treasury is full. Giving out of it does not decrease anything from it. In Hadith al-Qudsi, he subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my slaves, we are the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you, to stand in one place and make a request of me, and I were to give everyone what he requested, that will not decrease what I have. Any more than a little decrease the sea it puts into it. So ask your Lord whatever you wish. Ask your Lord everything from the world and the hereafter. Ask him for anything small or big. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, let every one of you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his every need, until he asks him for the soles of his foot and asks him for the strap of his sandals when it breaks. We should not miss this opportunity, but engage ourselves in the remembrance of Allah prayers, and we should increase the recitation of the Quran, and we should not get tired of reciting the Quran. Our time on this earth is limited. Nobody knows when his time is going to be over, and he will be called by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he must answer the call. We have this Ramadan, but none of us is sure whether we will still be here for any more Ramadan again. And this is our last Friday of this Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept all our fasting, accept all our supplications. And also, anybody that contributed to the air condition, it was purchased, it is here behind the masjid, it will be fixed very soon. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant them Jannah and make their graves very full. Allahumma izz al-Islam wa al-Muslimin wa adil al-shirk al-mushrikin wa dammir kafat al-kafirin wa dammir a'da al-din wa suri ibadak al-muhidin. Allahumma suri ikhwanana fi bilad Falastin wa fi Sudan wa fi Yemen. Allahumma ja'al biladana Nigeria aminan mutma'inna wa sa'il jamil bilad al-Muslimin. Allahumma ja'alna min utaqai shahri Ramadan. اللهم اجعلنا من اتقاء شهر رمضان. اللهم اجعلنا من اتقاء شهر رمضان. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا واهدنا وارزقنا وارفعنا. اللهم انا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى والمغفرة. اللهم انا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى والمغفرة. اللهم اغفر لآبائنا وأمهاتنا وارحمهم برحمتك أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لوالدينا ولجميع المؤمنات ولجميع المسلمين والمسلمات أحياء وأمواتا. عباد الله إن الله أمركم شيئا بدا فيه بنفسه وسلم فيه وملائكته فقال ان الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما صليت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى ال محمد كما باركت على ابراهيم وعلى ال ابراهيم انك حميد مجيد. عباد الله ان الله امر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعزكم لعلكم تذكرون. قوموا الى صلاتكم وارحموا.